Stein.
Yo, what up, English 12B? Are you ready for this goofy presentation? Because we're not. Yo, boy, ready for lunch? I want a sandwich.
What?
I know we just had lunch, but...
Yeah.
A young man from the 18th century saw lightning hit a tree, so changed his course of study. Went off to Ingolstadt to learn many things. Married his cousin, that was kind of the norm in that day.
Alabama? Oh wait, that's not a place yet.
Reanimated the monster, got up and went away. He created that thing, didn't give it a name. He created that thing, didn't give it a name. That Felix guy scared the monster away. The hatred in the monster just gave way.
Yo, this beat goes hard. Did you make it?
Nah, I found it on the internet, remember? We ran out of time, yo.
The monster begins his own education. The creature discovers Victor's notebook, which explains how he's created. The monster he talks to a blind man, by man, that at least he's scared of the monster out of the house. Wow. The monster was so angry, he just wanted to let it out. The next day, the monster goes back to the Lacey habitat. Oh crap, the landlord got it back. Never saw or heard from the DeLaceys after that. After burning the DeLacy cops to nothing more than ash, the monster moved on off to Geneva a minute later to find Victor Frankenstein, who? Oh, that's his creator. After a few weeks of cold feet and cold cheeks, arrived in Geneva, found a small boy peeking in the trees. The boy was terrified and yelled for his father. The monster got hot and strangled him. The boy was no longer. Taking the locket the boy had, that's too bad. And so tragic, only nine, it's so sad. But the story continues, so sit there and be mad. Finding a barn, the monster stays the night. Finds a girl who was sleeping alright. The monster mad at the world because he couldn't get a girl. Because his ugly face made you really want to hurl. Locket from its pocket, dropped it, landing in the girl's little pocket. Who on earth could stop it? The monster so evil, he just would love to pop it. Remember, the girl in the barn was said to be the murderer of the poor dead boy in his father's arms. The girl was hanged for a crime she didn't commit. And the monster ran off to the freezing cold mountains, where Victor would soon meet him to talk about an agreement. I want a mate, someone to love, someone who won't run away when they see him. When people look at me like that, I just want to peel their face off and clean them.
Hey, where'd the beat go? Hey, William, give me a new beat. Yeah, that one. Yeah.
Monster hates, wants a date, confessed the murders without straying. Wants a bride for the rest of his days. Victor knows it will be a mistake, given the option to make it a mate for both of the monsters to run away. Victor agrees, makes the monster family. The bride will just be as ugly as can be. Victor got all the stress, is making another monster for the best. Victor loving his father knows his distress. Victor asks Alphonse if he can go to England and he consents. Victor decides to go to get some more knowledge by the professionals who are doing a similar project. Victor and his best friend Henry go off to England wary, afraid of the monster, 8 feet tall and not just ugly but scary. Victor decides to work on the second thing, making that work with Henry in reach. They get invited from a friend in Scotland, so they head north to see what's popping. Victor's enjoying the country, but the fear of the second project still haunts the...
Yeah, boy.
Shut up.